Okay, so I'm just driving down this canyon and I'm going really slow down canyons where I know there are, you know, ruins. And this one I was going really, really slow. I had my camera next to me and way high up I saw like this little like kind of black square and it looked kind of out of the ordinary. And so I thought, well, let's take a picture and then zoom in to see what it looks like. So I did and I'm like, whoa, that looks like a ruin or something. And so I pulled over and stopped. And I'm gonna go hike up there real fast to check it out.
200 foot elevation gain, maybe like 500 feet, 600 feet that way. It's just right up there.
Okay, here we go.
Kind of like this way.
Okay, I think I'm close, maybe.
So there it is, underneath that overhang. That's where I saw it.
Oh, it is a little ruin up there. Wow, that's cool.
Like two different types of masonry on it.
Wow,
that's all the way up here.
That is really cool. That is high up there.
Do you see what I'm saying about the two different types of masonry? One is like the stones and then with some mortar in it, and then that top side is just, looks like it's pure mortar with a couple, I can see some stones in it, but clearly different.
How do you get up there?
With a drone, of course. Look at this rock art. This is just right next to the granary. Oh, look, there's a little foot right here. So I'm not gonna touch it. You're not supposed to touch these, but look at my hand compared to that. That's the size of it. And this one, wow. So I've seen these before over by, where is it? In Utah, Sand Island petroglyphs, and also the Kachina panel, which is along the San Juan River. So with the little things on top of their heads. Yeah, I've seen that before. Maybe you have too.
So whoever built these, they usually take advantage of these nice little alcoves or small caves. Usually they're far away. They're hard to get to, obviously. I mean, I could get up there maybe, but... And they're high up, away from where, you know, squirrels and deer and bears and rhinos and stuff could get. And us Jeffs, we can't get up there too. So it's really cool though. Really, just really fun to see this. You might be wondering, like, what do these mean? What do they have to do with this granary? Are they related?
And that's the thing with rock art, is we just don't know. We just don't know what any of this means. I mean, this looks like an anthropomorph, which is a human-like figure with something on its head. Like, is that some type of like headdress or a mask that has going on top of his head or their head? And this foot, this little footprint, what does that mean? We don't know.
But look, somebody stood here where I'm standing right now and pecked into the rock face right here. And here we are 1,000 years later, you know, 800, 900, 1,000 years later or more, enjoying this. Okay, I just pulled over and I thought I saw something. Do you see it? How about now, do you see it?
Looks like a granary. Wow.
That is really cool. So notice the little stones and then the mortar.
Like a little rat made a home in there.
If you look closely, sometimes you can see fingerprints in the hardened mortar. Mortar was typically made from clay, sand, straw, or plant fibers, and of course, water.
see all of these fallen rock.
Looks like there was something else here. Oh yeah. Yeah, something else is here too. Oh my gosh. Look at this.
Corn cobs were pressed into the rock right here. Wow, it's 1, 2, 3. This is amazing. 4. So these are, not touching it. These are probably 4 or 5 inches long. Oh look, we put it right in there. That is really cool. Ancient corn cob impressions. And I just noticed something else. Right here on the edge of this boulder is the spiral petroglyph. Wow, a lot going on here, huh? There's a granary, there's probably a couple ruins over right here. Then you have this corn cob impression thing. Okay, so there's a lot more going on here than I thought there was.
Looks like there are some ruins in this little, oh, wow. Yeah, some potsherds.
This is cool. Look how they put those rocks up there like that.
I was not expecting this in here.
This is the backside.
Wow. Cool. See how they built this up right here?
I imagine this whole back wall was sealed at one time or another.
So after these two adventures, I got the drone out again one last time to check for more ruins. And it didn't take long until I saw this. Is it a cave or a mine? What is inside? I can't really tell. I'll raise the light level for the shadows and zoom in a bit so we can see better. Okay, what do you think is going on in here? Is it a cave or a mine? It might just be a short mine. Looking back on some drone footage, we can see some possible waste rock here, or I think it's technically called muck. After already doing several hikes this afternoon, I didn't really have energy to hike up to this thing. Maybe on another trip though, I'll do it.